Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Welcome on this beautiful September wedding day. Really no better place to be than when your special guests and witness joining together the union of this wonderful couple, Nicholas Madole and Megan Hesling, stand before you, family and friends, to declare publicly their love and commitment to one another and to be joined in marriage. Now, this is more than a social or civil occasion because it's the declaration of their hearts. They know each other well, and they know that each other's hearts are with them. They're very special in the union already together. So we're here just to celebrate with them this new phase in their journey. You seek to encourage one another, you bring joy to one another and comfort in times of sorrow and health and all those good things that make a great relationship. So I would ask, who presents Megan to be married to him? So let us pray. Lord, we ask you to bless this couple as they join in union of man and woman. Help them to grow and become strong in their union. Help them to celebrate and nourish their love every day. We pray that what God has joined together, let no man separate. And we pray in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So Nick and Megan would just like to take a moment and I speak for them and thank you for the way that you've supported them and shared your love and encouragement over the years. Your support in their lives has been very active. And that's why we've been invited to this very intimate and wonderful event. I speak for them and say thank you all for being here to celebrate in this joyous day. They would also like to just take a moment to remember those who are not here. It is a very special moment because we know that these folks who have passed to the other side are very excited and happy for the both of you. And of course, it is your dear mother, and her spirit is with you today, both of you, Nick and Megan, and Nick, your aunts Linda Mahoney and Sharon Hyman, and grandparents as well. So we just pause with me for a moment. Nick and Megan, your love story is fantastic, and it's amazing, it really is, and I really enjoy getting to know you a little bit. Thank you for letting me in to your lives in preparation for your wedding ceremony. It is one of life's richest surprises when you go out one evening here in Grand Rapids, hanging out with some friends, maybe causing some trouble down at McFadden's, and you run into Nick, and you see him and have a little bit of interaction and then decide to go over and give a big hug before you left. And that was magical. Because you decided, Nick, to pursue her after that evening. So it was a very fabulous experience. And then it's life's finest experience when you, Nick, took the time to enter to get engaged at the birthday bash contest for B93. And you post, and I'll tell you, that was an unbelievable video that I watched. And if you haven't seen it, you need to get onto it. And of course, Megan, you said yes. It is a sacred day today when these two people realize that they want to spend the rest of their lives together and enter into marriage, and they stand before us today. It is a joyous day when a wedding arrives, family gathers from here and there to meet up, to celebrate your love. And that's what a wedding is all about. It's a wedding celebration. Only once in your life you find someone who can completely turn your world around. You tell them things that you've never shared with another soul, and they like you. They absorb every word of it. They want to hear more. Nick, you commented that Megan makes me feel selfless, that happiness is a priority, even over your own pleasure, and that you would do anything necessary to bring happiness to us all. What a gift and a guide. When something wonderful happens, you can't wait to tell each other about it, knowing that they'll share the excitement. You're not embarrassed to cry with each other. And you've been through some difficult times, but it's only made you love and upon you because you've endured it together. Megan, you mentioned you enjoy Nick's kind heart, sense of humor with the ability to make you smile, whatever the circumstances, to bring joy into your life. That's a gift. Megan and Nick, you find strength in knowing you have a true friend, a soulmate, who will remain loyal to the end. Life seems completely different and exciting and worthwhile since you met each other. Life's colors seem brighter, more brilliant. Laughter seems part of your daily life. You enjoy exploring new places and new beverages together. Walking the dog, sitting around a fire, or just hanging out with family. You have fun. Could I recommend that you keep having fun? Because fun is fun, and it keeps you together. You try never to intentionally hurt one another's feelings and make each other feel like you're not good enough, but rather you work on building one another up. You found a safe place, a harbor. You protect each other. Nick, you mentioned that when you're with Megan, you sense comfort. And then you said it's just difficult to put into words what you feel. You can be yourself and not worry about what others think of you because each of you have love for each other, the kind of love that won't pressure one another to jump on any hoops to do things that are impossible. You think of this person on every occasion and everything you do because you have discovered the real meaning of love. Yes, Nick and Megan, your bond was first formed when the two of you chose to combine your separate lives into one. You made already a mutual commitment to love each other in an atmosphere of care and consideration and respect. You are partners in life working together to bring out the best in each other, for each other, and striving to be the most that you can. This vow ceremony that you're about to enter into is a moment that is sacred and very special. You are about to share your special promise before these friends. It comes from the deepest part of your soul. Your shared experiences have brought you together and forged this bond of love. And now, I would ask you, what tokens have you brought today as a symbol of your love and devotion? Love freely given has no giver, no receiver. For each the giver and each the receiver. The wedding ring is a symbol, invisible form, of the unbroken circle of your love. That wherever you go, you may always return to your shared life together. May these rings always call to mind the power of your love as you go about your day. And may their circular form remind you the love given freely comes back around again and again and again. Holy Father in heaven, bless these rings. Bless the exchange of these rings and Nick and Megan as they share their covenant of love in the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. And I ask you, Nick, are you prepared to share your promise and be Megan's husband?
I am.
Please repeat after me. I, Nick, take you, Megan.
I, Nick, take you, Megan.
To be my wedded wife.
To have
and
to hold.
From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer or poorer. In sickness or in health. To love and to cherish. Till death do us part. And here too I pledge you my faithfulness. I give myself wholly to you. This hour. And I promise to guard, cherish, and protect you in all the days of your life. I give myself to you completely, and I promise to love you always. From this day, with this prayer, amen. And Megan, are you prepared to share your promise and to be Nick's wife? Please repeat it with me. I'm Megan in faith, honesty, and love. Take you, Nick, to be my wedded husband. I love you. You are my best friend. Today I give myself to you in marriage. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you, to comfort you in times of sorrow and struggle. I promise to love you in good times and in bad, when life seems easy and when it seems hard. I promise to cherish you and to always hold you in highest regard. These things I give to you today and all the days of my life. This ring, I need it. So Megan and Nick, through the years you have grown into the people you are today, and you are very special. These honored candles here on the table represent you, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Each of you holds its unique beauty, strength, and character. You now stand on your own with wholeness without the need of anything else. But when the two candles that are lit light the center candle, represents an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. Your lives together as one, lighting up your world and the lives of those around you. We don't know what lies ahead. for the road turns and bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to hug each other often, laugh loud, talk more, and argue less. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing or no one is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams, and fears, even though they may not always understand. Help them to learn from each other and to help each other grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that there is a design and a purpose in their lives, as in the world, and no matter what happens to them, they can hold on to each other and know that things have a way of working out for the good. Help them to create for their children a peaceful, stable love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. But most of all, dear God, help them to keep lit the torch of love that they now share in their hearts, so that by their loving example, they may pass on the light of love to their children and to their children's children forever. So Nick and Megan, you have chosen each other. You've declared your love and purpose before your family and your friends. You've made your pledge of love to each other, symbolized by the giving and receiving of rings. So without further ado, I will pronounce you husband and wife. And you may kiss.
Thank you.